Hi everyone, welcome back to Faith Unfiltered Kids. This is your catechist Mary Ann. Like every year, the Sunday following the Feast of Pentecost, we celebrate the Feast of the Holy Trinity. The Holy Trinity, consisting of the Father, Son and Spirit, are three persons of God with one divine nature, and hence we refer to them as one God. We see the Holy Trinity actually present in two important passages in the Gospel: at the baptism of Jesus and at the transfiguration of Jesus. Now, understanding the three persons in one God is a big mystery that can only be unlocked by faith. Do you know what Saint Augustine compared this mystery to? He said, unlocking this mystery is like digging a hole and pouring an ocean into it, which is near impossible. However, if you look closely, it is pretty easy to understand this concept when you look at things around us. Take for example this shamrock leaf used by Saint Patrick to explain the Trinity. This is one leaf made up of three distinct yet equal segments. Each leaf segment represents the Father, Son and Spirit. Now let us look at the things around us. I have this egg which I have boiled to avoid a mess. It has three parts: the external shell, the white of the egg, and the yellow yolk. Yet three different parts form one egg. So next time you enjoy the egg, remember the Holy Trinity. Next, I have three types of flour. Now I mix all three in a bowl to make one flour. Now, even though it is one flour, you can't deny that three different flours exist in one. I can make a batter out of this flour and make some yummy dosas. Let's look at the next. I have a glass of water, and to this I add some sugar and salt and stir it. Both dissolve in water completely and the water seems plain. But now when I taste it, it is both sweet and salty. So you see, three distinct characteristics make one. Take three different colored chalks, powder them and make one chalk. All three gel in so well, you can't make out the difference. Now let's have a look at this. I have three candles, all of them lit. I bring the flames together and you can see that it is one flame. You can't distinguish which flame is of which candle. Now, when you take decisions, for example, if you want to buy a gift for someone and you decided on a perfume, you go to the shop, smell the perfume, and you know the fragrance, and your heart tells you if it is perfect to buy. To make one decision, you used your brain, heart, and senses in such a short time. Can you distinguish between the three and say that you used one more than the other? Similarly, one body, mind and soul makes one human person. To think a little beyond, characteristics of both mother and father, as well as your own unique characteristics, make a person who they are. So children, the Holy Trinity is the same way. They are three distinct persons, yet they are one together. You cannot distinguish the three in one grace you receive. At every Eucharist, we celebrate the Holy Trinity. I hope these simple everyday things will help you recognize the Trinity as one God. Bye.